What's up, everybody? I'm Batman. I'm Pirate Batman. And, today we're here to discuss about life. And, some life lessons that we can learn from video games. You see, this idea came up when I saw a YouTube video about, well, these things, and I wanted to say it on my opinion and just letting you know. Life is tough, okay? And if you can read this, well, it's all gibberish. Actually, they mean a lot. If you can read it, then good for you. If you can't, here's the first game. The Dragon Cancer, played by Jacksepticeye, PewDiePie, Markiplier. And we should all spend time with our family and loved ones, and life should be appreciated. That's what I'm doing. I'm talking to you guys, make me feel better. Appreciating my life, I gotta do what I gotta do. I'm staying fit by not eating because I don't wanna eat. I'm on a very unhealthy diet. I didn't eat only one meal this day, which was chicken. Yesterday, this video was recorded on 25th, 1st, 2024. And I ate yesterday. And I still appreciate my life. Do whatever I want to do, just not caring what happens to me. That's the only thing. See, if I'm looking kind of down or sad, it's because my dad's in the hospital, and he's probably going to the hospital right now. I don't know what's gonna happen, I don't want to know, to be honest. I mean, anything could happen. And Dragon Cancer, my dad doesn't have cancer, but he has something that is attacking his heart and his lungs. Next up, we have Majora's Mask, The Legend of Zelda. Time cannot stop, so see my hair? It grows because of time. It grows because of time. If time was stopped, I would still look like this for the next infinite years. next infinity, further above and beyond. Time doesn't stop. Eventually, one day we're gonna die, and if we don't die, we're gonna overpopulate everything. We will be an infestation. And next up is Daisy. It's probably a post-apocalyptic game. I think I've heard about it. I don't like these FPS games. I'm still UI Spider-Man, by the way. I mean, Damien. Well, from DayZ, we can learn that never trust anyone at all. Especially if it's a stranger. Stranger danger. Always remember that, kids. Even if you're a grown-up, you could be kidnapped. Just because you think you're an adult, you don't think people are gonna steal your kidneys and sell them on the dark web. That's gonna happen. This is the real world. And not everything goes according to plan. Never does. Next up, Dark Souls. I'll sum this all up in one after I finish this. Dark Souls is a great lesson for how you improve yourself, not how you just smash your keyboard again and again and again. But all video games are the same, not just Dark Souls. Failing is an opportunity to learn. You fail your maths class, get a better teacher, understand more, go to maths tuitions. If you don't like maths, it's probably because you don't understand it. And if you do understand it and you still don't like it, it's maybe because you're lazy. Or some other reason. I mean, honestly, if you can understand it, it's just probably easier for you. But if you know how to do it and you're a little slow, I get it. We get pissed off all the time at every exam. But next up, Bioshock Infinite. Never stop asking why until you find out why. Never trust someone fully without learning their true inner deeper secrets. Because you don't know their plan. Like Hitler. Adolf Hitler is the best example. In my class, I learned that Hitler was not only a douchebag. Hitler is actually a world speaker, a speech maker, actually. See, he does a lot of speeches, and see, he gets credit for it. What can I say? Hitler is just that awesome. He was famous in Germany. He was so famous in Germany, he rocked the whole country. And after that, he slowly grew up into power, more power, more power, more and more, and just keep on going. Never stop. Until he ruled Germany. And what did he do? He killed all the Jews. Well, not all the Jews. Well, all the Jews, technically all the Jews in the country of Germany. And next up we have Final Fantasy Stronger Together. I know I've said never trust a stranger, but you can trust friends. But that is if you have loyal friends and trustworthy friends, like BFFs. Try to find out about their history more now or then. Because if they're secretly an assassin trying to kill you for money, yeah, that's not gonna be good. Let me tell you, that's never gonna be good at all. It's the worst. Next up, Shadow of Colossus. Paradox of Nature. And according to the video that I saw, the paradox of nature is basically, how do I say this? How much do you go for something? Do you just do it all? You should know how to use the world. You don't just kill it. You should know also how to control it. Use it. Stop killing trees for no reason. Stop using plastic. Why even invent plastic? At least plastic bottles, at least recycle. Look guys, it doesn't hurt, and I know it's lame, but hey, you're the one who clicked on this video, and life lessons are meant to be learned from, just like Dark Souls. Next up, my favorite, Fallout. My favorite video game franchise, except for the first and second one, and the third one, because it plays a role as the main character. But all it's about is, even in small talk, the smallest sentence can lead to a huge problem. Even a small, hey bro, you look like an ant, but you can't. That could cause some suspicion. Are you trying to mess with me, bro? The person would say. That teaches you about life. So don't be a dickbag in real life. Never be bad. Don't do bad to, think you're going okay and you're speaking. Never mind. Just forget. Just do you. Just be the way you are. Just don't talk at all. But, you can talk to your friends. Close friends. Just try not to say something mean to them. Try not to be like Andrew Tate towards women. Or like Aisha Speed and Indians. Because called him I Shall Meet. I'm having a tough time breathing. And the next up is also a new favorite, which is What Remains of Edith Finch. Okay, this game is a suicidal one. In this game, you play as a character who works a very boring job, which is cutting fish heads. I gotta say, it is boring. I'm not gonna lie, it is very boring. So, he decides one day to dream it while he's doing work. And then at the end of the game, you get crowned as king. Because you play as a he. But for that, you have to bend down your head. Why, you may ask? Let me tell you the answer. You bend your head where you cut the fish's head. Except, it's not the fish's head you cut off. It's your own. Not yours, the player's, the video game character's. That's it. I'm done. Dark. Tired of that guy. Look who it is. It's the Joker. My favorite perfume. Villain. Not sponsored. I wish they did. Anyways. I'm gonna sum it all up. Basically, just appreciate your life. Okay. Appreciate every second of it, even when you're sick, even when you're having a tummy ache that's horribly painful, very painful indeed. Whatever is happening, whatever bad, whatever good, let it happen. It's life. Instead of thinking, you get one life, and you may die anytime. Think of this. You only die once. You live every day. Or you may live every moment that you may die in. Think of it that way. Change it. Why not? Why don't we change it into a positive attitude? Huh? It's a good mental health issue. Like what? I'm not sleeping. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. The devil's hour. I'm scared. Yes, I am. But that doesn't stop me from being happy. I got a family. I got no love because my girlfriends broke up with me, ex-girlfriends, whatever. Even though I'm in depression, I do whatever I like. I hear music, I go to school, I see my friends, I get bored, which is far better than being depressed. Let me excuse me, shit. see stars. Yeah. I hope this teaches you something, that just be great in all you want to do. Hey, just do you, man. Just do what you like. Mike Tyson never stopped boxing. I mean, he did, but he still did get a great name, though, didn't he? Why? Because all those years, since 13, he trained, never giving up, willingly sacrificing something and using his strength and using his shortness. He put on a weight vest on him just so he could be short. He could be 5 foot tall and beat up folks who are 6 foot tall in boxing, in the heavyweight boxing ring. Just because of that, he used his own shortness, which was actually a disadvantage for a lot of boxers at that age, I mean, that time period. And this guy just found a way, like a cheat code, because he never gave up. And Muhammad Ali, I love his poems. They are so poetic. They are beautiful. You appreciate it. You listen to Ed Sheeran or Dua Lipa, or I don't know if he sings songs or not, but Justin Bieber, etc. Blah blah blah. More, so many people. Well, listen, it's still the same. Well, guys, that's the end of this video, and I am your favorite pirate Batman for this video, only for this one. Maybe coming October, and maybe for that I'll be as the Joker or Loki. Anyways, that's it. Peace, guys. And I've been Friendly Neighborhood Damien.